Are you Jack?
Aren't you a little short for a paratrooper?
What? Oh, the uniform. I'm Daniel Faraday. I'm here to rescue you.
You're who?
I'm here to rescue. I got your opportunity. I'm here with Ben Kenobi.
Ben Kenobi?
Nice.
I'm from the freighter. We locked in on your signal.
Great, so how do we get to your freighter?
Huh, I hadn't really thought of that. Is this rain feel like wetter than normal to you?
What the hell are you talking about, Daniel?
Never mind then.
So me and Kate saw a helicopter fly by here a couple minutes ago. Is that where you're gonna leave us?
Oh yeah, I guess we can use that to get off the island.
Great, so you wanna lead us there?
To what?
To the f***ing helicopter, Dan. Oh, that's what you're gonna do? That's what's happening right now? You're just gonna do that as a thriller? That's why you're here? Just to do a little Michael Jacksoning for us? Get the fuck out of here. I'm sick of being in the rain. Always rains in the jungle for no good reason. It's hot. I'd really like to get rescued though now, to be honest. I mean, really, you could sit out here in the rain all day and just watch you do your dance, but I mean, I got things to do. Places to go, people to see. And as you can tell, this really sucks. A lot of rain. Today would be nice. Literally.
Oh yeah, it's this way, yeah, it's this way.
So, John, when are we going to play rock band?
As soon as we get to the barracks. First, we have a little errand to run, and he is going to help us.
Me? What do you want me to do?
You're going to help me find some booze for the party.
What makes you think I know anything about anything? At all?
The island has shown me some things, Ben.
Yeah! Fill this up again!
Now, if I untie you, Ben, you're not gonna run away, are you? You and I have been through this before.
Henry, if I open up this door and let you out, you won't try to run away, will you?
Of course not, John.
And I never lie either. It's not like I'm the leader of the others or anything.
All right. Why don't you tidy the place up a little bit while I go get something for my cereal?
Sure, John.
You won't run off now, will you?
Of course not. Well, John, if you're going to untie me, that's just a risk you're going to have to take.
Not really.
of a whore! Shot me in the thigh! Who does that?
Ah. You won't be running very far with one leg.
It's like an inch away from my balls! God damn it, Locke!
Everyone head back to the barracks. We'll be there as soon as we get the rest of the supplies.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel Air." I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said freshen it a dice in the mirror. If anything, I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, man, forget it, yo, home's the Bel Air. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, "Yo, home, smell you later." Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there to sit on my throne as the Prince of Bel Air.